what has happened at the end of this trip is today, I came into Jan Treloar's lounge, where there was a red chair, old red chairs with battered paint, folding up beach chairs, leaning against the wall that she had selected because of their lovely shapes and because they meant something to her. But when I came into the room, the sunlight was streaming through them and creating dynamic shadows, just like the things that I would stop and take photographs of and paint in China. And I walked into their lounge with their newly painted wall of elephant's breath. What a bizarre name. This lovely grey. Each morning when I've come into the room, I've seen the shadows falling across the floor. Whenever I've been in another room, I've come rushing in with my camera to take the pictures of the changing shadows. And I came and sat down and started a painting. Now, the shadows are moving, literally moving as you look at them. And so I was having to work incredibly quickly. And it seemed to me that the point of the painting was not the actual shadow, it was the light shapes that were left in between the dark shapes. So I did the thing that watercolour painters aren't supposed to do. I picked up my white gouache paint and I just started. I had done a bit of pencil drawing, but then I just started drawing in white gouache and fitting the colours in round them. And the grey is just a mass of reflected colours. It's reflecting green from outside, around the window it's reflecting colours bouncing off. I just got a glimpse of sea and sky outside, and I like that idea of the glimpse coming through there.